So welcome, guys. Welcome to our first ever jazz at McGann-Mercy, modeled off of jazz at Lincoln Center, because they keep jazz alive, and so do we. It's our job as well, because you all know jazz was the first American music. It was born here by Europe, and it was changed by us. Right? We do that. We tend to do that, right? We tend to change things. That's okay, though. We did this for the better. Blues, jazz, rock, all here tonight for you guys. We hope you guys enjoy the atmosphere. This is definitely something new we were trying. We thought it'd be fun for you guys to relax and enjoy some cheese and crackers and by candlelight while you listen to some good tunes. Most importantly, though, is that tonight isn't just about jazz music. It's about jazz education. Every time a student or the ensemble plays a song, there's something new to it that you get the chance to learn, whether it's individually or in the ensemble. And we like to focus on that here. We really like to keep it alive. So, we're going to get this ball rolling with our contemporary Andrews sisters, and they are Grace O'Shaughnessy, Grace Lukaczynski, and Rebecca Lukaczynski singing Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy for you guys.
He blows today to the bar in boogie rhythm. He can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with them. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B. He's some boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B. And when he plays boogie woogie bugle, he's as busy as a buzzy bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump and into the bar. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B. Ta-da-da, totally-ada, totally-ada, do-do, he blows today to the bar. He can't blow a note, he's playing with them. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B. He puts the boys to sleep with boogie every night and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet, because we know how he plays when someone gives him a beat. He really breaks it up when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B. A toot, a toot, a toodly attitude. He blows the day to the bar in boogie rhythm. He can't blow it out unless the bass and guitar is playing with them. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy, Company B.
To introduce McGann-Mercy Vocal Jazz Ensemble, directed by Mr. Jamie Calandro.
Build me up, don't break my heart. Build me up, don't break my heart.
Hey, hey, hey. Unveiling these groups. This is possibly been the most fun I've had rehearsing with these groups. I mean, it's just such a nice, tight-knit group. I look forward to these rehearsals 99% of the days. They, with all the other things we do with the chamber and the chorus and most of them in the play, it's really commendable, all the hard work they put in. And, I'm very happy that it shows, and I'm sure they are as well. So we're going to keep it right on going. Our soloist for this one is Grace Lukaczynski, and we have two more for you. And can you see me back there? Ready? Obviously, the challenge is we aren't an all-male group, far from it. We have one. So what was, I had to reharmonize it, and Rebecca Lukaczynski, who soloed on In the Still of the Night, was instrumental, no pun intended, in helping us with the reharmonization and the rearrangement of the song to suit a mostly female group as well. So she kind of, you know, she came down on her study hall, and we listened to frame by frame and note by note and measure by measure over and over again until we really got it right. So a lot went into this. So big thank you on that, Rebecca. And also, got to call attention every time. I'm not really sure what we do when Brandon graduates, but percussion, Brandon is always there.
Introduce Mr. Trelewicz and our very, very talented instrumental jazz ensemble.
How about that vocal jazz ensemble, huh? Right? Jazz is alive and well in the voices of the kids of Mercy, not just of the single ones, of the ensemble ones now. It is awesome. I was so happy Mr. Calandro was ready and willing to do all of that. It was great because he put in a lot of hard work as well as those kids did. So we're going to start you guys off tonight, and I do want to introduce our featured percussionist for the first song. He has been a huge
part of the music program in general, from everything from organizing the music behind my back, to bringing in a gong for our spring concert, to just being the most flexible percussionist I know. So give a round of applause as he plays Are You Ready to Rock on drums, Mr. Josh Haley. Brothers, you have James Brown, you have all those guys, of course, your famous funk artists. This song we're actually doing for our competition in a month at Music in the Parks, and this one is by the contemporary artist of Gordon Goodwin, and it's called There's the Rub. better saxophone. He's been playing saxophone for me since fourth grade. I've known him since fourth grade when I taught at Dayton Avenue at ESM. And when did he get taller than me? I don't know. I love it. Great job, dude. Nice job. Okay, the next tune is called It's Been a Long, Long Time. This tune is probably one of our hardest, even though you might not think it. It's based off of Count Basie's Little Darlin', which was written back in the 40s by Neil Hefti. And you can ask any jazz musician about playing a jazz ballad. It's one of the toughest things to do because you have to stop, you have to listen, you have to be with the band. You can't be an individual in this case. And this song gives us a chance to just sit back, relax, and just play with each other and listen to each other. So this is a slow ballad that we hope you'll enjoy in the style of Little Darlin'. If any of you guys know that song. It's not called Little Darlin', but it has that style to it. All right. So, as you can see, a slow ballad is tough to articulate and accent together and really listen to each other. It takes a lot of work, and believe it or not, they actually almost sight-read that piece in general when we first checked it out last month. So that was a really cool, I guess if you want to say, lesson for all of them to just stop, slow down, get away from the funk, the blues, the jazz, and, well, the fast jazz, and kind of sink into something slower. So it really helps broaden their horizons. I guess as midway through our set here, I just want to make a little announcement as we just received it about 2 weeks ago. The National Association for Music Educators works closely with the NAM Foundation, which is the National Association for Music Merchants, which is a national organization that we are a part of. And back in November, I applied for an award that is a support of outstanding music education, and only select schools and districts from across the nation win it. And we were awarded the Support Music Merit Award, which is for individual schools, that outstanding award for support for music education. So we were awarded that, nationally recognized across the United States, along with 500 other districts, other schools, I may say. And this year, 4,000 schools applied. And we were one of the awards. So it's a huge thing for us to finally be nationally recognized for music. And it kind of helps get the word out there that we mean business. So that's what we're talking about. All right, the next tune you guys should all recognize. Take a step up a few decades from where we just were. And I hope you guys enjoy this one. I can't believe it's gone this fast. The next tune is a tune that has been around forever. And if you guys were here in the winter concert, We played a little second line for you. Right? We spoke about how jazz funerals work with the funeral march first, and then after they hit a certain point, they celebrate the person's life by playing a second line. And they usually play Joe Avery's Blues, which is a traditional song. So this song has a twist to it. Gives you the funeral march as well as the second line. So we hope you guys like the style for this one. This one was a big grasp in the beginning, learning about a funeral march and jazz funeral march and playing it in the style with each other. So it's very, very cool. So hope you enjoy it. Evening. I hope you guys have enjoyed the night of learning about what we are doing here with jazz, and that it's not just entertainment, that it is a well-rounded experience, an educational, beneficial experience for these kids, because they're not just rocking, they're playing, they're actually becoming better musicians. And I could see it from some of these kids that I've had for so long. And I do want to make just a quick recognition of some of the kids you see up here, because this is their last jazz show. And while my heart breaks, it also is wide open for them in their future experiences with music. So there's a few people. One is Bridget Edwards. I've known her since seventh grade. She's been around. Been with me since then. Another is Kevin Dong, as you can see. This is his first year playing jazz, leading the sax section. Then we have Mr. Dale Kelly. I've known him since fourth grade. We also have Christian Burns on first trombone. I got Alex Sikorsky on the piano over there. Sam Carrigan, our first year jazz player on guitar. And last but not least, his first year playing with us as well, Josh Elia. And of course, I can't forget, another student I've had since seventh grade, playing clarinet, which most people will raise an eyebrow at me, but I always have kept clarinets in my jazz band. And I'm proud of it, because they're meant to be in it. Come on, Benny Goodman, Artie Shaw, where would we be without the King of Swing, right? So Jason Bodichuk, ladies and gentlemen. And our last tune for the night, singing, I think, better than Aretha Franklin, is our vocal soloist, a tradition we've had here for 7 years now. She's the seventh singer with the jazz ensemble. Please give it up for Grace Lukaczynski.
Make sure everybody knows it. This is my 13th year at Mercy now. And when I started here, There was no music program. There were five kids that I managed to get to sing in liturgies that I grouped with six or seven faculty members to make it not be five kids at a liturgy. And seven years ago, he joined us and did this. And this is it now. You know, we have 80-piece choirs and 70-piece bands and 30-piece jazz bands and 35-piece chamber choirs, and we just added another group, and we have the play next week, and we put in a lot of work, but I mean, it's, you have to know it's them. Like, your kids are amazing. And we cherish our time with them, and I'm sure you, as your parents, you know that, but your kids really are amazing. So thank you for sending them here, and thank you for everything you do for us.
Everybody, please get on the same page, and we'll see you in a month at the spring concert. Good night, everybody.